Hi, I'm Norman Wildberger, and today we're going to have a quiz on rational trigonometry. A chance to solidify your understanding, a chance to practice and apply the theory that you've learned in this series to some practical problems. Mathematics is not just about learning and listening, it's also about learning by doing. Okay, first problem. We have a triangle whose side lengths are 4, 3, and 2. These are lengths, not quadrances. Okay? Many of the problems in this quiz will start with distances, like in real life. We still want to work things out with rational trigonometry and end up with distances, though. All right, so the first question is a kind of a warm-up. What are the quadrances and spreads of this triangle, and what is the quadria and the area of the triangle? Question number two is the height of a crane. Here's a crane, and we have two observation points, A and B, which are separated by a distance of 100. We measure the spread at A to the top of the crane, that's S, it's 4/5. We measure the spread at B, it's R, 16 over 25. Your job is to find out the height of this crane. Question three. We have a symmetrical kite whose distances are 2, 2, 5, and 5. That's not quite enough to specify the shape of the kite. We need one more piece of information, and I'll tell you that this spread here is 1 quarter. Again, that's the spread between those two sides. The spread of a quarter is the same as an angle of 30 degrees. And the question is to find these quantities A, B, and C. All right, our question number four concerns an A4 sheet of paper. I remind you that the ratios of the sides are 1 to root 2, and we'll assume that our units are chosen so that this is actually the distance 1, and that's actually distance root 2. The four corners are A, B, C, and D. And we're going to fold this piece of paper along this diagonal. So I'm going to crease it there, and then I'm going to fold it over. So the D goes up to D prime. And the question is, what is the distance between B and D prime, between this point and that point? Question number five concerns a cyclic quadrilateral. That is four points forming a quadrilateral which lie on a circle. It's called a cyclic quadrilateral. And this particular one has side lengths 2, 3, 4, and 5. So again, these are lengths of sides. That determines the quadrilateral's shape and size completely. We want to know what is the radius of the circle. Our sixth problem concerns a process called inversion in a circle. That's something we're going to talk about in a future video at some point. So we've got a circle right here, its center is C, and we have a vertical and a horizontal line through that center. And I'm choosing a point A on this vertical line, and I'm going to show you how to create a new point B by the following process. We start with this point D here on the horizontal line, draw this line through A till we get to the point E where it intersects the circle, and then we reflect this point E across this vertical line to get F. So we reflect E to F. All right. And then we draw the line between D and F, intersecting the vertical circle at B. So if A was down here a little bit further, then E would be there, F would be out there, and the B would be further out. Okay. Closer A is to here, further out B is to there, closer A is to here, and closer B is to there. Okay, what we want to show is the following. That if this circle has radius R, then this distance from A to C times this distance from B to C always equals R squared. Okay. So these are distances, not quadrances, but of course you could easily rephrase this in terms of quadrances just by squaring everything. And our final, most challenging question concerns three different lines emanating from the sides of a triangle. I've chosen the same triangle as in our first question, triangle with side lengths 4, 3, and 2. Triangle A1, A2, A3. And first we draw the midpoint of this side, call it M1, and that's the median, right? The line from the vertex to the midpoint. First question is to find the length of that median, the distance between here and here. Second thing that we do is we draw up a perpendicular from A2 to the other side. Call that point F2. We want to know what is the length of that altitude. And finally, from this point, we draw a bisector. If you like an angle bisector or a vertex bisector, these two spreads, this one here and this one here, are equal. So this vertex bisector intersects the other side at B3, and we would like to know what is that length, the distance between A3 and B3. Now, for more professional mathematicians or enthusiastic students, here's a slightly more sophisticated thing to think about. I don't claim that these three lines are exactly in this shape here. So the question is, are these three lines actually concurrent in this situation? And if not, what conditions on the triangle would ensure that these three points are concurrent? All right, so those are seven good questions. They're a chance for you to practice your skills. Proceed methodically, okay? In each question, if you don't know what to do, write down what you know, write down clearly what you need to know, and try to figure out a way of getting from here to there. Maybe some intermediate things that you have to calculate before you can get to the final answer directly. Okay. Some of the questions might involve a little bit of lateral thinking. I hope you enjoy the quiz. It will be fun, I hope. It will give you a challenge. And next time, we'll have the solutions, but also I'll give you some hints at the beginning of the video. I hope you'll join me for that. I'm Norm Wildberger. Thanks for listening.